delivered by Joseph Omoni Bashoro, Professor of Urban and Regional Planning. A round of applause for the Honourable Speaker. In line with the tradition of our institution, the chairman of today's occasion is also our Vice Chancellor, Professor Adeyemi Temitayo Olabiji. A round of applause for Madam Vice Chancellor. With Madam Vice Chancellor of this side of the divide, we have the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academy, Professor Deji Rufus Ogunseyemi. Our registrar, Chief Scribe of our institution, and Secretary to Council is Mr. Richard Adeyinka Arifalu. Welcome, you, sir. The Chancellor of the Exchequer, Abosa, is Mr. Julius Adefola Adeshoba. You are welcome, sir. Our deans are also with us. Leading the team, the College of our deans, is Professor Adebola Festus Aye Somi, Dean School of Physical Sciences, as well as Chairman Committee of Deans. Welcome, you, sir. We also have the Dean School of Agriculture and Agricultural Technology, Professor Oluwato Faramade Oshodam. You are welcome. The Dean School of Computing, Professor Boniface Kayobianishi, is also with us. Welcome, you, sir. The Dean School of Basic Medical Sciences, Dr. Victor Okoluko Ukwanya, is with us. You are welcome, sir. Professor Isaac Olani Ajay is the Dean School of Environmental Technology. You are welcome, sir. Representing the Dean School of Health and Mineral Sciences is Professor Olaoluwa Akintoluwa. You are welcome, sir. The Dean School of Logistics and Information Technology, Professor Akinwumi Fatailawa. In absentia, we greet him. Then the Dean School of Life Sciences, Professor Michael Olufemi Ashama. You are welcome, sir. Professor Oluwayo Beko Olusoji is the Dean of Graduate Studies. A round of applause for him. We have recognized all our deans, and at this point, we'd like to bring to the podium our Vice Chancellor, Professor Adeyemi Temitayo Olabiji, for our address.
Deputy Vice Chancellor Academy, the Registrar, the Bursar, other principal officers of the University, my lords, spiritual and temporal, top government functionaries here present, the inaugural lecturer of today, Professor Joseph Omoni Bashoro, deans, directors, and heads of department, especially the Dean of Environment, School of Environmental Technology, distinguished members of Senate and population, eminent scholars and friends of the university, gentlemen of the press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. I am delighted to welcome you to the 151st inaugural lecture of the Federal University of Technology and Planning, titled Transformation of Rural Knowledge Through Regional Agricultural Planning, to be delivered by a professor of Urban and Regional Planning, School of Environmental Technology. I am pleased to welcome our spiritual and traditional leaders, top government functionaries, captains of industry, friends of the university, and the entire staff and students of the university. I welcome very warmly the immediate and extended family members, I congratulate and rejoice with Professor Joseph Omoni Bashoro on this academic milestone. Joseph Omoni Bashoro was born on 27th December 1964 in the Kerala State. He attended St. Joseph's African Church Primary School in Moro, Odigbo local government area on those states from September 1968 to June 1975. Thereafter, he attended African Church Comprehensive High School in Kerala Ekiti, Ekiti State from September 1975 to June 1980. Between September 1982 and July 1983, he studied at the Federal School of Arts and Science, Ondo, and in October 1983, he gained admission into Ondo State Polytechnic, Ondo, where he obtained national and higher national diploma in town and regional planning at Upper Primate in July 1985 and August 1988, respectively. He obtained postgraduate diploma and master in urban and regional planning from Enugu State University of Science and Technology, Enugu, in October 1996 and January 1999, respectively. He later bagged a doctoral degree in urban and regional planning from the Federal University of Technology in October 2008. He completed his Bachelor of Science degree in Environmental Sciences and Resource Management with a first-class honors from the National Open University in January 2010. Joseph Basho started his teaching career as part-time lecturer, BSc. Program, Department of Social Sciences, University of Nigeria, in program application with the College of Education in July 1997. He joined the services of the Federal University of Technology Accra in October 2000 as assistant lecturer in the Department of Urban and Regional Planning and was appointed professor on 1st October 2016. Professor Joseph Omani Ibashoto has distinguished himself as a scholar of record in his area of specialization. He has spread over 50 articles in the reputable journals, referred conference proceedings, and technical reports. He has also authored and made significant contributions to books. He has successfully mentored many young academics in the Department of Urban and Regional Planning. He has supervised 9 master's dissertations and 7 doctoral theses. He has also supervised 12 postgraduate diploma dissertations, as well as many undergraduate students' projects. And he has attended and presented papers at many local and international conferences. In the course of his education and career, Joseph Omoni Ibashoto has received many distinctions and research grants, most significant of which are: he was best student and award winner, postgraduate diploma graduating student of 1983-95 academic session, Department of Urban and Regional Planning, University of Science and Technology. He was best student and award winner, higher national diploma graduating student of 1987-88 academic session, Department of Town and Regional Planning, Ondo State Polytechnic, Owo. He was 2012-2013 most disciplined lecturer, male, in Futa, from the Breeders, a Futa-based academic association, and 2018 Southwest Nigeria Outstanding Lecturer of the Year Award, organized by Southwest Nigeria Excellence Award Organization. He won in conjunction with other researchers 2 million tech fund university-based research grants on e-land pricing in residential housing flexibility mix in Abuja, Nigeria in 2016. Professor Bashola has served as external examiner and assessor in many tertiary institutions, including Enugu State University of Science and Technology and Human Resources, Iwa Polytechnic Award. He is an assessor to many local and international academic and professional journals, including the Journal of Small Business Management, USA. is also a reviewer for Ghana Journal of Geography, University of Ghana, Negra Institute of Town Planners Journal, and Futa Journal of Management and Technology. Professor Bachelor is a member of several professional bodies, such as International Society of Development and Sustainability in Japan, Negra Institute of Town Planners, Negra Environmental Society, and Negra Institute of Management. He is a registered town planner, a fellow strategic institute for natural resources and human development, and fellow Institute of Policy Management Development. At different times, Professor Bachelor served the university in different administrative capacities, among which are, he was head of Department of Urban and Regional Planning in Futa from August 1, 2022 to date. He was acting director, Center for Continuing Education in Futa, 2016 to 2018. He was member Futa Campus Planning Development and Notification Committee, also between 2016 and 2018. He was member University Staff Disciplinary Committee from 2016 to 2020. He was Associate Director, University Diploma in Science Program, Center for Continuing Education, Federal University of Technology, between 2011 and 2016. And he is a member of the board of the Center for Continuing Education in Futa from 2008 to date. Outside of the university, he served in various capacities, such as acting as secretary, publicity committee for the Nigerian Institute of Town Planners, Ondo State Chapter. He is a member Education and Publication Committee, Nigeria Institute of Town Planners, Ondo State Chapter. He also is the auditor, Ikere Social Club, Ikere Equity, from 2012 to date. He has participated in many professional assignments outside the university, including being a reviewer of the NEC paper on managing major cities, Blueprint for Nigeria's Sustainable Urban Development. That one is for 2018 to 2050. Review of NEC undergraduate and postgraduate accreditation instruments. He's also a member of the review committee of the 70% NEC core curriculum minimum academic standard for BTEC Urban and Regional Planning in Nigerian University. He was part of the preparation of master plan for the University of Adoekiti, Ekiti State. Also for Federal Polytechnic in Nasarawa State, and Adagbapunya, New Town in Ilaje, local government area of those states. He was part of the conduct of baseline survey for environmental problems in the oil producing communities of Ondo State, a UNDP Ondo State government project in 2006. Professor Bachelor enjoys reading and traveling, and he is a lover of sports. He has passion for playing table tennis and badminton, and is happily married, and the union is blessed with three promising children. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, more than half of Nigerian population lives in the rural areas as agrarians whose occupation is critical to the country's economy. These rural regions constitute the economically backward areas of Nigeria. Today's lecture affirms that some rural settlements are significant regional agro-goals whose potential can be unleashed with regional planning policies for steady growth and development of Nigeria rural regions. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Professor Joseph Omoni Bachelor as he presents the 151th Inaugural Lecture of the University. Titled Transformation of Food Analytics to Regional Agro-Food. Thank you.
Deputy Vice Chancellor of Delhi, the graduate from Order of the Part of the Arts of the University, the Director of the Head of Department of Police, my Lord, Mr. and Mentor, Fellow Academic and Professional Colleagues, Distinguished Guests and Friends of the University, Gentlemen of the Press, Distinguished Ladies and Gentlemen, we carry on. By His grace, I stand before this great audience today to present the 154th Inaugural Lecture of the Federal University of Technology at Plain and Deal. It is the 16th Department of Urban and Regional Planning, and the second for my specialization, that is regional development planning. Today's lecture is remarkable in the history of my career as I render this account of my academic stewardship, culminating in my professorship in urban and regional planning. Indeed, the God has been marvelous, generous, and supportive thought through my voyage in the search for knowledge. For him, I return all places. The Vice Chancellor, I do all with a strong delight in heart and exercise which I admire beauty of nature and creativity. My initial intention in life was to advance in this English field and end up as a renowned artist. This motive for this movement is my father's instruction that I should develop an education irrespective of my chosen career. My father, as a teacher during my secondary school days, observed the way I opened and selected this field in our small garden where I enjoyed all forms of planting on straight lines. This practice became habitual for so many years, and the growth of this plant became also fascinating. Thus, nodding me on the choice of either becoming an artist, an agriculturist, or an environmentalist, realizing a trend in the effective use of confined space later changed my reputation from art to local land arrangement, that I eventually became a plant planner to me, therefore, is not a coincidence. I joined the service of the university in 2000 as an assistant lecturer in the Department of Urban and Regional Planning. I enrolled for my PhD immediately, which is a focus on agriculture within the context of regional planning. Most of my research outputs were from this standpoint and have been disseminated in academic outlets globally. The basic areas involved in my research as actions are regional development planning and strategies, agricultural potentials of a rice producing rural regions, improving its quality and value chain, enhancing regional supply and environmental quality, while mitigating poverty in the economic development concept and trying to regional planning objectives. My inaugural lecture titled Transformation of Rural Narratives through regional agricultural planning has therefore crystallized on the dynamics of regional development to enable policymakers to appreciate the significant role of agriculture in the transformation of rural practices. Evolution of planning. The concept of planning started with God during the creation of the earth, which was planned for 7 years. The process was systematic, such that the pace of development motivated the subsequent one based on the relevance to the farmer. To complement this innovative effort, the sustainability as created by God has remained a major task from generation to regeneration. We recall that the Stone Age of 2.6 million years ago, which lasted about 3,300 BC, the Middle Age era, which spanned through the 5th to 15th century, and the Renaissance period of the 17th century were significant periods of human life. Literature records that the Industrial Revolution era
that was characterized by human environmental problems prompted Pioneer Planners to advocate reforms through planning in the 18th century. The definition and ideology of planning. Literally, planning is a blueprint for the future. It also represents policy actions set up in a chronological order to regulate an activity from 2014. Town planners usually engage in people in the environmental planning, which are urban and regional planning. Urban planning helps in regulating the balance of the various forms of farm and urban communities in a harmonious manner. Regional planning, on the other hand, as a distinct aspect of planning, has a broader scope and emanates from the viewpoint of economic development across the geographical districts, comprising rural settlements, towns, and cities. Of special interest here is the perspective of rural settlements, which most policymakers often overlook. With this consciousness, regional planning is employed to determine where economic development occurs unequally in a region and the manner in which organization of economic space affects the pace and structure of economic growth. A global view on regional planning. For the purpose of this lecture, experiences were drawn from Europe, consisting of developed nations, Asia, with fairly developed nations, and Africa, of typically developing nations, to appreciate their regional development strategies some years back. The British experience. Between 1945 and 1960, the goal of Great Britain was demarcated into two broad regions, the more prosperous regions of South and Midlands, and the less prosperous regions of the North Scotland and Wales. The latter, which was the focus of the British planning policy, based on the average weekly earnings of people, was allocated to 8% in factory jobs in capital intensive and labor saving production factories to meet the health needs of people, unlike the more prosperous regions that were already commercial hubs and seats of expanding service industries. The days as presented in Figure 1. The French experience. Population in France after the Second World War rapidly grew up, with two-thirds concentrating in the urban areas of the northern and eastern France, and above all in Paris in the 1960s. Paris region alone, which is only 2% of the area of France, then accommodated 19% of its population, 29% of industrial jobs, one quarter of the nation's civil servants, one third of the higher education students, and nearly two thirds of all the commercial headquarters for 1994. In contrast, the rural west, 55% of the area, has 7% of the population and only 24% of the industrial jobs. In view of this sharp regional disparity, the country tries to develop a system of economic planning, not on state ownership of all resources, but on a lean economy where about half the total investment was in private hands. In 1970, 22 economic planning regions were constructed in the Paris region alone, as contained in Figure 2. The regions represented elaborate machinery through which employment in manufacturing and tertiary activities were redistributed, with the ultimate goal of promoting the modernization of farming in rural areas, enhancing commercial functions, modern branches of manufacturing and higher education in the metropole de Libre, already designated in 1963. In this manner, governments systematically diverted public investment into this pool, thus strengthening their economic potential while attracting private capital. South Korea and the poverty programs in the city regions. Right from the 1960s, urban population in South Korea was dominated by about 61% of the African poor. In response to the situation, the central government initiated anti-poverty programs for the city regions with job creation, vocational training, and financial aid programs for the self-employed to enhance their income. South Africa and Regional Services Councils in the 1980s. Local government structure of regional administration was dominant in South Africa up till the early 1980s. For a long time, white local government authority retained administrative control over the colored and Indian areas, as well as the natives who were residents in the urban areas. This subsidiation resulted in the restructuring of the local authorities with the creation of new regional services councils in 1983, as contained in the budget. This represents a constitutional reform strategy in the context of regional finances of black local government under apartheid. Lemon, 1990. Regional planning policies. In Nigeria, regional planning policies in Nigeria began after independence with the Niger Delta Development Board, which was set up in 1961, October 2004, and entrenched in the first and second, and formed by grant for the third national development plan when the river basin development projects under different authorities came on. Apparently, the creation of states and local government areas, as well as geopolitical zones, is the cornerstone of Nigerian regional development policies today. The Lagos Ogun State Metropolitan Corridor Plan is an exciting regional plan for the development of the boundary regions of the two states. Just like those states were producing the Corridor of City Area Development Commission, set up for the development of its coastal region. Quite obvious in the process is that a particular regional program is initiated, progressing towards a solution. Metaphors of rural areas. The Vice Chancellor, there's no definite international definition of a rural area. Version and Grammar 2015C maintain that whichever way it is built, a rural area has spatial, occupational, and structural dimensions. In the words of OECD 2011, the word rural was first used by the United States Bureau of Census in 1874 to define the population of a country exclusive of any city or town with 8,000 or more inhabitants, Critica 1982. No wonder the U.S. Department of Health and Human Resources described the rural area as all populations, houses, and territory not included within an urban area. In the United Kingdom, rural areas are typically settlements with less than 10,000 populations. The six categories are described in Figure 4. From that illustration, the major components of the rural areas are towns, villages, and hamlets, either in clusters or dispersed settlements. Ogun 2011 or 2010 developed a definition index, including the values of agriculture, agricultural production, employment, demography, education, and the flows of money, goods, and people. However, a definition based on agriculture is universally accepted in literature, so the Ogun 2021. And because rural areas are dominated by farms, villages, and peasant communities, which in most cases are deficient in basic facilities and infrastructure. In Nigerian rural analogy, more than 2/3 of the Nigerian population whose primary occupation is agriculture reside in rural areas. The rural sector constitutes the economically backward areas in Nigeria, and has been so since the colonial days. Olubunmi Ambassador, 2015. Since the early 1970s, several federal government policies and programs have emerged as strategies to improve the rural and agricultural sector of the economy, some of which are currently defunct or abandoned or have been restructured by successive governments. This includes the River Basin Development Authority Program, Farm settlement scheme, Directorate of Rural and Rural Infrastructure, Better Lives for Rural Women, Rural Water Supply Scheme, Agriculture Development Program, Rural Electrification Scheme, National Accelerated Food Production Program, Pasture and Grazing Reserve, among others. These programs were set up to abate rural urban migration and boost the welfare of the rural areas. Daramala Ambassador in 2014 B discovered that the local government initiatives notwithstanding, the programs do not significantly impact the rural people for some obvious reasons. First is the instability in government, as many had to continue beyond the government that initiated them. Second is the inadequate information and data on the rural potentials and needs of the rural dwellers. And third is the general lack of enthusiasm for the development of rural areas. Regional agriculture, a conceptual clarification. Evidence abounds in literature that most regions of the world cannot develop naturally without planning intervention. But from 2008A, many countries introduced policies to meet certain needs. In some developed countries like Canada, United Kingdom, France, and USA, some measures are adopted to address gaps in regional economies. The United Kingdom, for instance, had attempted to reduce the disparities between the North and Southern regions through the enactment of laws. In Canada, some complex regional planning programs have been undertaken in provinces by the Ministry of Regional Economic Expansion to reduce regional inequalities. In the USA, the concern for the depressed area led to the emergence of the Department of Commerce and Economic Development Administration to initiate growth centers to generate income and employment in marginal agricultural districts. Jonas et al. 2002, Daramala Ambassador 2014. After political independence in 1995, Estonia, a country in modern Europe, adopted the National Agricultural Strategy for the development of its rural economy. The strategy had the basic objectives of promoting competitive enterprises, efficient market structure, and international trade relations, which are necessary prerequisites to achieving the broader goals of improving the rural standard of living. FAO 1997. The principal concern of most governments in developing countries today is to exploit available resources in rural areas for development. Version 2010. The concept of agriculture, therefore, was adopted as a form in this lecture to offer deductive explanation for the emergence and significance of the sector in a region. It anchors on two distinct terms, agro and poor. Agro is the agricultural content of regional planning and the potential for equalizing development in the regional context. Poor, on the other hand, is a differentiating point from other parts of equal importance or uniformity of character in the designated region as illustrated in the profile. It was derived from the local model, which implies a center with some strategic indications of growth. Pero 1950. The assumption of the group concept predicates on the ideas of economic welfare of the region, subject to a dominant agricultural activity whose product influences the performance of many other activities that produce some centrifugal and spread the threat of the whole regional economy. Version 2013, the objective function that is associated in the agricultural concept is the economic attribute of a particular segment that reflects on features of central place in a growth-inducing geographic area. With regional agricultural planning, the focus is on development of a major rural community to become self-sustained. by addressing equal problems of poverty, rising unemployment, and growing inequality associated with rural stagnation and projection of economic ladder. Worthy of note is the fact that such capital is not contained, but has built a system involving channels along which movements of an ideal product occur with a good stress, which is effective demand that sustains its production. In the majority, a regional agricultural social research laboratory, the Vice Chancellor, in the southwestern part of Nigeria, it is stated the main one of the least developed economically, but from 2009C and 2012E. Recent observation, however, reveals that it has put asset up by the boost power. About 87% of the state population are farmers, of which 70% are actively engaged in rice production, according to NYSA 2002. Of 4 million rice regions or towns, including the Ibadan, Igbo, and Imo, in the state, Igbo has national reputation for producing peculiarly tasty local rice. Rice production constitutes the economic base of this locality, as it controls a relatively large market area and enjoys easiest accessibility to the state capital, that is Abuja, where it attracts high patronage. Different rice processing and marketing activities also complements rice farming to transform the town to a significant agro-pool. Part of the 2019, 2010C, 2013D, Bachelor of Contract 2008. In determining the catchment area for the local rights, the access opportunity model was employed. Further efforts were made to generate the breaking point of the local rights using such indicators as the location of the market rights, source of rice, and distance to the agricultural. The breaking point model, which is a derivative of the latest law of regional gravitation, was applied. The gravity model predicts how trips emanating from a particular center divert to other centers. The fact is that the distance from the agricultural, which is the major trip point, the intensity of trading of the rice declines to a level known as breaking point, where the supply may cease to exist. That's from 2013. The nexus of rice and food security. Rice is indisputably significant to the economy of many nations in the world. It is important to the economy of the United States, that is the largest exporter of rice in the world, and Southern Europe. It is a staple diet in Japan and the principal crop in India. Taiwan heavily depends on its rice production, being the second largest exporter of rice in the world. Rice is the mainstay of the economy of Vietnam, where the tropical climate supports 2 rice seasons per year. NYSA 2002 maintains that rice is a staple crop throughout West Africa, especially in Cote d'Ivoire, the Gambia, Guinea-Bissau, Liberia, Burkina Faso, Senegal, and Sierra Leone. Specifically, Nigeria, Cote d'Ivoire, Zaire, and Madagascar are among the biggest producers of all types of rice in Africa back in 2010. Observably, rice is the most important food product in the world and indeed the principal food of human race, Bachelor and Bachelor in 2010. Nigerians prefer the local rice, the relatives, because of its taste and aroma, Yom Tov 2001, Bachelor and Bachelor in 2010. In reality, the local rice is cheaper than the imported rice, and it is demanded more in the urban than rural areas, where there are more people. And the main reason in Nigeria is probably facing persistent shortage. Ensuring food security in the country, therefore, requires stable food production accessibility to vital resources to meet daily food needs of the population. My research contribution is to rural transformation in Nigeria, the vital sector, and distinguished audience. I have characteristically described the conditions of the rural areas of Nigeria and the cities, which I tell rural narratives in this lecture. My research process has been on how to change the narratives, that is, the approval of developmental indices through various planning research and labels, designed to impact the rural areas in the city in particular. The main focus here is the production system of local rights as a community of economic labor with dynamic implications for infrastructure development that will lead to economic, social, and physical transformation of Ibema and its rural regions, the Agbo region and the adopted studies. Bachelor 2009 C, 2010 C, and 2012 C studied the Ibema Rice region and discovered that six local government areas, including Ado, Ileoko Ifeoluto, Idosi, Boyin, Oye, and Ikoyi, had the potential of strong interconnections and well-established economic ties with the Agbo. In this study, efforts were made to unveil the phenomenon underlying the consumption of rice, while policy measures were unveiled for more technocratic approach by the producers and handlers of the product for adherence to acceptable standards of food production. The geographical influence of rice consumption from Ibema was also determined with a view to promoting regional economic growth, with a target on rice development and empirical analysis of acquisition of rice migrant crops in Ibema region assessed that the distribution of rice in the area depends on the ability of marketers to satisfy the complex web of purchases and sales by the diversity of household types. Agropole rice production and the rice cultivation. As observed by Bachelor 2008A, 77% of residents of Ibema were farmers, of which 74% specialized in rice farming and virtually all completed manually. Two in every three rice farmers were males. About 88% of those who cultivate rice were ladies of the town, the job which many claim to have been doing for more than 10 years. Unfortunately, land put under cultivation by 93.5% of the farmers was less than 10 acres annually due to their poor financial position and inability to embark on mechanized tillage. Quite often, the worsening local economic conditions increased pressure on the young ones to assist and work longer hours, Bachelor and Bachelor in 2000. Identification and analysis of the basic factors controlling rice cultivation generally at the agricultural. Bachelor and Bachelor in 2010 investigated certain variables that are critical to rice productivity at the agricultural. From table 1, only 5 of the variables, such as marital status, area of land cultivated, market for the rice, labor engagement, and use of agrochemicals impact significantly the quantity of rice harvested annually by farmers at the agricultural. Results of our regression analysis indicated that if efforts are made to increase the five variables by 100%, there will be a corresponding increase in harvest by 52.9%, 19.9%, 17.97%, 16.1%, and 17.7% respectively, as presented in the plan. The rice processing issue. Bachelor 2013G and Bachelor 2010B found out that only four variables, that is, marital status, expenditure on processing, training acquired before processing, and provision of store significantly affect mode of processing rice at the agricultural. These variables were introduced stepwise into a model working in racial resort in Timbuktu. From the findings, status and trade show inverse relationship with mood, and this implies that the high number of females and low level of training acquired before processes increased by 100%, mode of operation will depreciate by 15.4% and 23.5% respectively. The same increase in expenditure and provision of stock will expand processing operation by 36.9% and 17.9% respectively. Rice marketing system and operation. Six local government areas have already been carved out as the major area of influence of human rights, which also tends to mark the region of marketing of local rice in the state, as presented in Figure 6. Out of the total 16 local government areas in the state, Igbo region alone accommodates about 44.2% of the state population and is relatively the major marketing areas of the local rice, back from 2008-2009. Marketers of national characteristics. By 2018-2013, found out that 71.9% of the local rice sellers source the product from Igbo. 11.4%, 6.2%, and 10.2% from Ikole, Ijebu, and outside the state respectively. Most of these rice marketers are females, as reflected in Figure 7, who specialize in trading, and majority prefer to locate in the neighborhood markets and operate periodically. In the region, many of them earn between 50,000 and 100,000 naira annually and are married. A bivariate analysis of the marketers' behavior was carried out in 2003, and the bicentennial correlation coefficient reveals that the income of the marketers is highly limited with scope of population, availability of the rice, and location of the marketers. Apparently, majority of the rice marketers are constrained by funds, as many are likely to minimize movement to the agro and may be compelled to undertake the activity within a small confine, preferably in their own towns. A typical local rice baby in the region is of the opinion that he has a group of customers with whom he can sustain very high frequency of market transaction within the usual scope. Substantial percentage of these traders patronize Igbemon due to the popularity of the rice. This explains the high assumption or the mode of operation of the marketers with nature of marketing and price of the market. Many of the marketers sell periodically in neighborhood markets. In the rural region, the density of population is low, with paucity of daily markets on account of port of partition system. The implication of this is that cost of food items may likely increase with the prevailing cost of flour by the traders around November and March 2013. And with poverty on the increase, nature of rice marketing is bound to be on retail scale using the Congo, which is the common unit of measurement at the usual price of 1,100 naira. Rice consumers experience. Bachelor of 2009 CE, it means that the level of education of the rice consumer has a significant relationship with sex. More females seek the rice more than the males. Typically, these females occupy low paid jobs and are more engaged in the informal sector than men. Bachelor 2013 is a situation that perpetuates the active entry into modern low education and continued cycle of poverty. In the region, most consumers consider the rice to be fairly available. Generally, availability has depended heavily on seasonality and level of production at source, where the degree of production is still regarded as baseline. Interestingly, the need to strengthen production indicates very high relationship with the consumer's level of obligation, household size, rice quality, and price. The general response of needs is high, suggesting a strong linkage between production and consumption of the rice. Given that majority of the consumers are literate, who are conscious of the local source with large families, low production at the minimum may not be able to offer the supply that it meets regional needs. For the rural economies to gain momentum, therefore, a high level of sufficiency must be guaranteed. The fact is that the consumers, usually of low income, prefer the low quality rice, and this can basis support services and finance for easier access to supply. The attitudes of consumers in relation to price reveal that cost of daily consumption of the local rice is tolerable, thus indicating the need to strengthen production at source. Conclusion. The vital sir and distinguished audience. In the course of this lecture, it has been established that a greater proportion of Nigerian population lives in rural areas, and their primary occupation is agriculture, which is the cornerstone of the country's economy. Most often, they are deprived of government attention, hence constitute the economically backward areas of Nigeria. Interestingly, some of these rural centers are significant regional agro-hubs that serve development input, which will formalize support for the regional population. Transforming the rural narratives, therefore, is equivalent of rejuvenating their economies with sound regional planning policies and frameworks that recognize the spatial diversities in agricultural potentials for steady growth and development to emerge in the area through the agri-hubs. Recommendations. The Vice Chancellor. Nigeria no doubt is blessed with a number of agri-hubs whose potentials can turn around the economic fortunes of the rural areas. What is required at the moment is ensuring that our regional development strategies correspond with the complex character of rural development. The agri-hubs are hubs of economic prosperity that can create wealth, job opportunities, and promote development projects by the local people, government, and donor agencies to reduce regional inequalities. On this note, the following recommendations are set forth. One, the federal and state government must focus attention on agricultural development plans for the country by delineating regions of identified rural settlements with the monopoly of production of an essential agricultural product for a special regional planning policy. Two, regional rural development commission should be set up in collaboration with state agricultural development projects, national agencies like the River Basin Development Authority, National Seed Service, and State Ministry of Agriculture and Natural Resources to introduce regional development projects and programs. Three, the state government will support the RRDC project with funds to complement the federal government special fund from the International Fund for Agricultural Development, this item, and other external funds. Four, the state government should prioritize investment in infrastructure, especially roads, water, electricity, health, schools and housing, to promote the regional character of the products as an agriculture. Five, the RRDC must strengthen the marketing infrastructure and organization through regional markets development strategy at the agriculture. Six, regional coordination of the marketers of the population with the establishment of product marketing depot is necessary to restructure the local and periodic sales of the agricultural products. Seven, promotion of gender balance in food production is essential to improve household economy and the agriculture, and develop the existing complementarity in the production process for efficiency with open access like sexes. 8. The agricultural input supply policy of the state government should be decentralized, with the constitution of a regional center for agricultural input supply to represent the depot at the capital and ensure their regular supply and effective distribution to the farmers at subsidized cost for sustainable production. 9. Government through the RRDC must collaborate with stakeholders such as the Minister of Commerce and Industry, Agriculture, Local Government, and so on to organize training programs and awareness of food safety together with enforcement of food related standards and regulations for quality improvement of the agro products. 10. Enhancement of the value chain for the agro product through value enhancement strategy is essential to further process them into vital food items such as flour, egg, cake, noodles, wine, etc., and increase transaction capacity building of the producers and enlarge trade network within and outside the region for sustainable development. I wish the President to find gratitude to the Almighty God, the one who knows the end of the beginning. He gave me the opportunity of today, which is a rare privilege, and a large testimony of His grace and mercy. To Him, I return all glory and adoration. The Vice Chancellor, a number of people have contributed to my success in life. I want to appreciate my late parents, Honorable James and Christian Bashalu, and Mrs. Comfort Bolande Bashalu, for their love and commitment to my upbringing, morally, spiritually, and academically. An inspiring statement of my late parents still lingers in my memory of today. After obtaining my PhD in 2008, he said, "Lee, we are delighted with your academic record, and we are optimistic that very soon we will be proud parents of the professors." Unfortunately, he died 3 and 5 years later. They really meant well for me, and I remain eternally grateful to them. I especially acknowledge the Vice Chancellor, who has served in this university since I joined the service of Fuka in 2000, a beauty named Professor E.A. Adeyemi, a Professor R.A. Christensen, Professor E.O. Adeyemi, Professor A.M. Bano, who discovered and brought me up as an administrator, Professor E.A. Pashaka, named Professor A.T. Darabala, and Professor D.A. Duwakwe. It's worthy of note that I served under the last call as Associate Director, University Diploma in Science Program, which later came to University Advanced Basic Science Program, and subsequently as Acting Director of Center for Continual Education. I got my appointment as leader and professor under the leadership of the last two, respectively. Becoming an initiative under the leadership of the current Vice Chancellor, Professor Adenike Edelidayo, is divine with bright hope of greater achievement during her tenure. May God help her. My gratitude goes to the past and present days of the School of Environmental Technology, FUTA, since my appointment, the good Professor Dio Olariwaju, my PhD supervisor, Professor S.R. Okuduri Lele, former Vice Chancellor of School of Tech, Ibuka, and Professor D.R. Okuduri, the current Deputy Vice Chancellor Academy, under whom I serve successively as of PhD. Professor J.A.B. Uwijili, Professor I.B. Kashi, and Professor I.O. Adi, under whom I'm currently the head, Department of Urban and Regional Planning. I'm thankful to other professors in this group, including Professor Osko Arayela, former Deputy Vice Chancellor of Academic, A.S. Ashara, E.A. Fadalu, former Deputy Vice Chancellor of Development, O.O. Obishoke, T.L. Akibo, former Deputy Vice Chancellor of Development, A.A. Taiwo, Y.M.T. Adedidi, M.O. Bello, G. Fadalu, H.O.G. Architecture, T.O. Igbo, M.A. Oyelowo, V.A. Bello, H.O.D. Estate Management, M.A. Adebayo, M.B. Ogunleye, E.B. Oladokunle, O.F. Brownlee, and O.A. Amadede. I acknowledge the sponsor, Dr. S.B. Adebayo. The school officer, Mr. O.A. Adeyemi, and Assistant Director of School Office, Mrs. O.A. Agulala, as well as my fellow H.O.D.s, whose names have been mentioned, and others such as Dr. P.O. Akani, J.A. Akala, B.E. Adiji, and H. Tata. The members of staff, Department of Urban and Regional Planning have been so supportive and are hereby appreciated. Professor J.O. Pashaki deserves my special gratitude. As my former lecturer at the Polytechnic, major PhD supervisor, major co-researcher, and mentor. Of particular recognition are Professor J.A.B. Ichigi, also my former lecturer at the Polytechnic, and a role model. O.B. Akibadiba, F.A. Omani, A.E. Olakunle, M.A. Oyelowo, A.A. Emmanuel, as well as of course M.O. Adani, O.O. Lotoma, A.O. Olusa, J.O. Uweye, O.F. Benesan, B.O. Olani, and I.O. Olani, Messrs. F.K. Alakani, A.G. Adeyemi, A. Adeyemi Olabesi, the T. Akubodi, O. Olufayo, Mrs. R.O. Akimbanle, E.A. Yoko, A.O. Omade, M.C. Ola Omade, A.F. Abdullah Faleli, R.V. Olusanya, and E.T. Ubanayi. May we always have the reason to celebrate. I cannot forget the close working relationship I have with my former directors at the Center for Continuing Education, FUTA. They include Professor Labo Elagide, Professor J.O. Olala, a strategist and great mobile developer, as well as my co-associate directors, including Professors S.S. Oziyama, F.I. Alam, E.A. Alam, others are Doctors E.F. Lassese, O.O. Aki Imola, E.O. Ayewa Deni, and O.M. Akinana. Your roles and that of other members of staff of the center are highly acknowledged. For my education, I wish to thank my primary school teachers for the sound academic foundation. I am equally grateful to my secondary school teachers at African Church Comprehensive High School in Kere, the school without failure, where you learn to be yourself in many different careers. I especially acknowledge my principal, the professor Yuhu Litegede, never allow any parent to carry the luggage of a child on the school gate. Mr. B. Obatayo, M. Obiyeku, S. Dada, and A. Olajide, the art master who developed my design skill. I appreciate my lecturers at the University of Science and Technology, NU, particularly Professor C. Abu Burundi, Chidi Ugu, my master's project advisor, B. Mwadiegi, Joy Yogasi, and O. Omen, Drs. A. F. Odi, and L. S. A. B. I highly appreciate you for the staff development assistance I have enjoyed, particularly during my PhD program, and the technical research grant and sponsorship of my participation at the 2015 International Conference on Humanities and synthesizes in New York, USA. I am deeply appreciative of the significant roles of the following personalities in my life at one time or the other. They include Barrister Mr. Kimbosade, Pastor Mrs. Adewale, Pastor S.K. Olorosola, Mrs. Ademi Gemini, late Professor Adewale Mutua, late Professor K.O. Ipimuriti, and late Lazisi Bashan, and not who like a father. Mr. Amis Oyewale, Pastor Ramola Joshua, and Pastor Fire Elisa. I acknowledge the thanks, the partnership I enjoyed in the Nigerian Southern Planet. I was student of company consultant and also of women town planners in Nigeria from the state chapter. The Kera Social Club, the pastoral and elders forum of RCCD Beauty Sanctuary, and Ajibu Gonsuki Association. I have enjoyed very cordial relationship with all my classmates. Some of them are here, present, and have sustained the confirmation to date. I say it to them. I am most grateful to my siblings, Charles Pastor Kabiyesi, Anish, Adeyemi, Adiku, Esther, Ayinka, for their constant support. My auntie, Mrs. Iduwakumbo, deserves special acknowledgement for standing in the gap of her late mother with assistant prayers. I am equally indebted to all my in-laws for the frequent visits and open arms afforded my family. May God reward for labor. Finally, I am grateful to my children, Tolu Bukola, Tolu Boke, and Abidamala, for the joy and peace of mind they give to me, and for sharing, always sharing my voice. God bless me. I most especially appreciate my grandmother, Mrs. Eli Adeyinka, for her affection and supportive clothes. It's a real gift to me, a priceless companion, confidant, and caring partner. Thank you for your understanding of all the thick and thin. For any other person who's been my confirmation, I stand at that. Thank you.
We have my sister and friend, Dr. Mrs. Monupe Olayeka Jaye. She is former registrar, also there in Africa. Thank you, ma'am, for always finding time. Professor Mrs. Yemisi Adewale. She is a member of the Governing Council, Africa. So, thank you for being here. We have today also Professor Isa Malagi Kazim, is the former Dean of SET, Fuchs School of Environmental Technology. Thank you, Prof. Professor Ola Rewaju, also former Dean of SET. Thank you, Prof, for coming. Thank you very much. He's here with Mama. Thank you for coming here. Today is SET Day. We also have Professor Ishaq Adekunle Amao, the acting pro-chancellor of the ABU, Zaria. Thank you again and again for always justifying that time. Dr. Mrs. J.O. Ogundede is the head of the Department of Chemistry, Fuoye, and she is also representing the head of service on those states. Thank you very much, ma'am. Today, also in our midst, we have our royal fathers, His Royal Majesty Oba Akinola Adeyemo III, the Oba Lemo of Ora Ekiti. Carlos Adiapenoli, Patapenese, Kirutene Apenowo, Ashapenene. Thanks for coming. We have His Royal Majesty Oba Charles Bashor Udidi, the Iyeja of Immortal Land. Kabesi Ekwefuwa. High Chief Mrs. Akani, the Yellow Day Oyo Kwedu of Ikere Kiti. Thank you very much, ma'am. And your final time. We also have our elders in our midst. Elder Deo, Jenny Lehin. Elder Deo, Jenny Lehin, thank you for coming. Elder Michael Oni. Thank you, sir. We have Elder Mrs. H.P. Olofinshayo. Thank you very much, ma'am. Elder Mrs. Idi Adeshina. Thank you, ma'am. Elder J.A. Adeyeye. Thank you very much, Elder. Elder J.A. Omaniyi. We also have Elder C.A. Onabodi. Thank you very much, sir. Elder Mrs. Tumi Adeyeji. Thank you, ma'am. Deacon S.T.F. Amao. Thank you very much, ma'am. Pastor Mrs. C.O. Esho. Thank you, Mama. We have TPF Olajimedi. These are professional colleagues of the North Director. We also have TPF Joshua Daramola from Federal Polytechnic Adwekiti. Thank you very much for your time. Honorable Olatunji Igogoji from Ikeda Ekiti. Honorable, we are very grateful. We have TPF Olajuja. Olajuja. Thank you. And TPF Mrs. Ademili. Thank you very much for coming. Finally, also, we want to recognize the families, the members of the family of the North Director. We have Mr. Henry Bashoron, son of the North Director. Rise, let us see you. We also have Mr. Emmanuel Bashoron, also son of the North Director. We have Mrs. Justina Bashoron, daughter of the North Director. And we also have the person that Professor Marshall described as a real gift, a priceless companion, confidence, and Thank you, ma'am, for being with your heart. I whispered to you recently, I think it's late, and I said, all women should go and force their husbands to deliver another letter so that they will understand, they will know how you will describe them. We have friends and families of the inaugural lecturer. We thank you for coming. The professional and academic colleagues of the lecturer who are present, we recognize and thank you. Members of the Redeemed Christian Church of God that have come to grace the occasion, thank you very much. We thank the gentlemen of the press, and we thank the most important group of people here present, great materials. Thank you very much.